Julian Traeger from Anglo Pacific's on the line with me this morning. Julian, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
An interesting investment here, Julian, acquiring a 4.25% stake in Labrador Iron Ore Royalty Corp, LIORC. What's the rationale here? Give us a bit more detail.
Well, I think it's a unique opportunity for us to get a significant exposure to a producing mine and royalty stream in a very good jurisdiction with a good operator, and getting exposure to very high quality product, which is also valued at a premium because it's low producing, and which also has significant expansion opportunity.
Well, I suppose you've mentioned a couple of points there, but as far as ticking the boxes for you, operated by a major and in a safe jurisdiction, two of the big ones that you like here as far as acquisitions or investments.
Yeah, exactly. So it's operated by Rio, and it's based in Canada, which is one of the better locations in the world for mining.
And why iron ore in particular here, Julian?
Well, I think iron ore, many people had written off as being oversupplied, but actually we think it has a better future. And indeed, since we started buying our position in the market over the last couple of months, the price of iron ore has gone up. But in particular, Labrador Iron Ore is exposed through the Iron Ore Company of Canada to high-quality concentrate as well as pellets. And both of those products in the iron ore space are trading at a very significant premium, levels which we haven't seen for some time and which we expect will continue to be the case given the fact that China is putting on restrictions based upon pollution requirements. And these products are much cleaner for the environment. So we think that there is a good prospect for this, and there is also the opportunity to potentially double the size of the mine.
And you're expecting this to be immediately accretive, contributing to Anglo's income in the second part of the year?
Yes, I think the forecasts from Bloomberg are that the company next year will pay an annual dividend rate of about 5 million Canadian. Obviously, there's a range around that. But we have financed this roughly, it's a $50 million investment. We've invested around $30 million of our cash balance, and we've borrowed about $20 million against our facility. But absent other royalty acquisitions, we expect that that borrowing will be fully repaid by the end of the year.
And through this deal here with LIORC, you've got a stake in IOC, and of course there's been some suggestions they could go public at some point on the Toronto Stock Exchange. So further upside to be had potentially?
Potentially, yes. We'll have to see how this story evolves. It's obviously really being driven by Rio Tinto and its objectives. But if the stock is listed, then that could create more upside for our investment.
This is, of course, your second iron ore investment, isn't it?
Yes, we do have development royalty effectively over a very prospective part of the Pilbara in Australia, which we expect BHP to develop in due course, but it probably won't come into production for about a decade, whereas obviously this one is already producing and developing and generating good income.
And iron ore, an area you'd like further exposure to, perhaps?
Well, I think it does start to move our exposure, and it's part of the transition as we diversify and reduce our coal exposure. This will increase our iron ore exposure from 5% to 20% of our net assets. It will reduce the Kestrel exposure from around 49% to around 40%. It will also boost our exposure to Canada significantly. So it is part of this journey we're on to diversify and get income from different commodities and also diversify geographically, but still being exposed to good jurisdictions.
And being, I think it's the second investment you've made this year, am I right? So you've got that momentum continuing here, that's picking up the acquisition momentum?
Well, I think as we are generating more and more income and we are going to be announcing our interim results next week, we are quickening up the pace of redeploying that cash flow into new royalties. This will be the second, as you say, of the year, but we do expect to complete another one or two before the year end as we continue to expand the portfolio.
Good to speak this morning, Julian. Thanks for your time.
Always a pleasure, Andrew. Thank you.